So hello and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play American Truck Simulator. And if you remember in the previous episode, we drove from San Fran down to Santa Maria, or just on the outskirts of it here at Cosine Mining. I found a job for us today, going down to El Centro, paying $75 per mile and $27,000 for doing 350 miles, which is just amazing compared, or thanks to anyway, the rescale. But we're back in the W900, and I have got a few things to talk about.
Okay, so as you can see, we got 5 hours and 54 minutes until we need to rest 4% on the truck. But yeah, let's get going. Does sound good, doesn't it? That cat engine. Even though it's only, in quotation marks, 375 brake horsepower, but just runs so nicely. I mean, if you've been watching this series for a long time, you would know that some episodes I have thought about upgrading it, but well, beyond that, episode, I don't know, mid-50s, and from since we got it, which was episode 8, we haven't really come to a point where I've needed anything more, so I can't just justify changing it. I really can't. I think I'm just going to focus on upgrading the fleet, expanding that, because especially now that we've got a bigger scale and therefore more money per job, well, if we get more drivers in, bigger trucks that can go further, the money's going to start coming in. So I think that's the best way around it, and then we can start putting some money back into our truck. Look at the scenery around here, it looks so good, doesn't it? Reduce speed ahead, okay. 45 zone, let's just slow it down a bit. But I think we're still averaging 5.7 miles to the gallon, which is weird, but 17,200 miles. It's getting on a bit now, this thing, it really is. Let's listen to it. But yeah, the new France DLC, or the Vive la France DLC, is coming out Monday, which is very exciting. And as you may have seen, some YouTubers have already, pre-release testers, beta testers, and all those people have got access to the DLC. Take a look out. So obviously the YouTubers have made some cool little intros and sort of promo videos, including Squirrel did one, and also Truck Game. And if you don't know Truck Game on YouTube, he doesn't upload that often, only when there's like a release for Euro Truck. He's all about, or American Truck that is, he's got about 3,000 subs, so go and have a look at his channel. He's actually the one who inspired me to do inspired me to do the time lapses every Monday, which I really enjoy making, and I'm sure you do, because you lot keep coming back and watching them, which I appreciate. But look at that. I think I remembered coming down here once and looking over here. I definitely do remember that scenery over there. But yeah, they about 5 YouTubers that I know have got access to the DLC early. I mean, I think the least amount of subscribers that one of them's got, that has had access, is about 1,100. Which, I don't know, I'd love SES to give me a free copy to take a look at. But yeah, obviously I haven't had these, so I do sort of think, the amount of subs that I've got now, 330 or so, dunno, there's not much point in SCS giving me a copy to take a look at, even though I am part of the community, but I'd love them if they did. I'd make some amazing videos of it, because that's what I enjoy. Okay, let's turn right here. So here we are in Santa Maria. This is the new town that has been added scale. Let's take a look at it. Seems like a pretty basic town, to be honest. Seafood, donut shop, Walbert. Yeah, it's a pretty basic town. But before we go and get the trailer, I think we'll go on a quick look around here. Come on, why are they going so slow? Oh, this is quite a wide little bit of a town, this. Four lanes on this road. It feels a bit wide for this little stretch. Right, we need to get over here. We'll go down here now, I think. Right, this little stretch of road. Just get the beans. So nice. Right, this is sort of the fake Tesla place, isn't it? It's very blocky, this sort of town. Like, it's very square, if you see what I mean. But there are quite a lot of undulations and stuff, which is really nice. But yeah, quite a square town, and I do like that little main high street right there in the centre with the four lanes. That's very cool. What's this cop car doing? I do notice they've changed most of the AI now. Are a lot more high res, and then the cop cars don't have the alloy wheels now, they have these sort of traditional Crown Victoria black and the chrome hubcap sort of style. Right, let's hope this trailer's still here. I believe we've just got enough time to get it set there, so 118, we do have to rest, remember. So this is going to take 9 hours, so that'll take us until midnight, and I mean, yeah, we should make it. If we're lucky, we should make it a little bit early. Right, where is it? Just there, apparently. Right, here it is. I'm used to going all the way around the back of this thing, but apparently not. Apparently it's in here. Nice little cool little section of this. I like it. Very rustic trailer, look at it. It's very old and used. And it sort of fits in with this area. If you look at that, there's all like broken boxes, signs ripped off the wall. It's very very cool here. Right, so we should be all attached now. Look at that. Our truck just stands out like a sore thumb. All nice and shiny and stuff, but it would be nice to get some dirt building up. 23 tons. SAF marine container. Right, are we gonna make this? I don't wanna hit that XC90. Put it in first. I don't think we're gonna make that. Maybe we are. It's so hard to judge in these longer nose trucks. Right, it doesn't matter if we hit the Prius. Who cares, but bada-beam, done. So let's get out of here. I think we'll go past the upgrade shop this time. But yeah, the new DLC, so whole of France reworked, and what I've seen so far from the various YouTubers and stuff, and people, pictures and stuff like that, I think it looks really, really good, and I'm so excited for it. I think it's a massive step, well not massive, but it's definitely a step up, sorry, I can't get my words out today. It's definitely a step up from Scandinavia, which was already amazing, really. Just the detail of France, I think it's going to be really good, all the small villages and everything like that. Because you don't really get tight corners, tight towns and everything under that description in the these games, American Truck especially, because everything's huge in America. Come on. Just turn my indicator off there. Oh, maybe not. If they beep at me, I'll be angry. What is wrong with the AI? Let's get down here. Do you like that white 389 in front? Honestly, the one that I drove on the time lapse a couple of weeks ago. Well, maybe these lights don't last that long. I think we made it. Yeah, cool. But yeah, that's Santa Maria for you. Those little back alleys and stuff. But yeah, it looks like a massive step up from previous DLCs, so obviously I'm going to be really excited to get driving around France. The thing that I'm not massively happy about is that the Renault Range T, as far as I know, is not going to come in the DLC, and it's nowhere really to be seen. I'm guessing they've still got licensing issues, so I'm not going to run an SCS if that's the case, because I'm sure they've got the model finished. Like, they have got loads of truck models finished in American Truck that is pretty much ready for a release, apart from they don't have the licenses, which is sort of hard trying to get truck manufacturers to license their products in this game. But I don't know, it would be really nice to see Renault Range T, because that was my plan. I was going to do Exploring France, and that was basically, that soon was going to be my chance to drive the brand new Renault Range T on a long distance, or for at least a series. It probably would have been 20 to 25 episodes maybe, because I'm sure it's going to be absolutely huge to explore everything like we did in Iceland. I believe Iceland was about 6 episodes, I can't quite remember, but it was quite a few, and that was Iceland, and there's basically just one big ring road, pretty much, with a road going through the centre. But look at this, this looks cool. But yeah, France is going to be huge. I'm still going to be doing that series, Exploring France, but my plan was to do it in the Renault Range T. So I'm going to have to find a different truck to do it. I did want to do a Renault. Maybe I'll get a Renault mod, modding one of the current trucks. I don't know if to get the Renault Range T mod. It doesn't look that good, to be honest. I'd rather wait for the proper SCS one, but I don't know. I was really, really hoping, and I was under the illusion that the Renault Range T would come with it, but nope, that is not the case. So basically what I'm going to ask you guys is for your mod suggestions. Now I'm probably going to start the series next week sometime. I've got no idea when I'm going to, what days I'm going to do it on, but next week is going to be, what's this? Is that going? So that about? I've got no idea what was that. I wish I stopped it and looked then, but no. So yeah, next week isn't going to be very good, so I've got a French speaking exam, which is awesome. Not so. Yeah. Next week is not going to be great. Same as this week. I've been, I don't know, I've just been really busy, and I don't know, I've got a lot of deadlines to finish with school for Christmas. I've got to finish a computing control assessment and an arts control assessment final piece, so yeah, I've got to be careful of this Mustang driver in front. He might spin out of control in a second, you never know. You know what, they're like... Since they're like engine brake though. What is with all this traffic? What is this all about? Why are we... Why... What's this 30-mile-an-hour speed limit doing here? What on earth is going on? Honestly, I've never seen traffic this bad. Wow. Oh, come on. Can't be done with this now. 55, let's go for it. Foot down. There goes the Range Rover. Are those rocks over there? So it's people. Cool. It's people on the beach. But yeah, I don't know what mod to do it in. Maybe I should do a Volvo mod. Because sort of Renault and Volvo sort of interlinked with each other. So maybe a Scania mod or any mods like that. Any mods that you want to see. And when the Range T does drop eventually, we will immediately switch to that. But I know what it'll be. We'll finish the series and then immediately... Hang on, I don't trust this. Why is it taking me this way? Why can't I? Oh no, I'm gonna... I hate that. It takes you the shortest distance that it can find. So I'm gonna have to get back on now. In fact, can I go through the town or something? Oh, there is a... I don't know what it is, but... discoverable something. And as we're off here anyway, we may as well go and get it. Great. Okay, it's a junction. Ludicrous. Look at that. Cash for cars. All cars. Santa Monica? Are we in LA? I don't know. I thought Santa Monica was like, sort of the beach area in LA. Right, let's get in this lane. I'm gonna have to do some dodgy U-turn in this yard, which might be difficult. They are coming around this corner. I don't get it. 55 limit here. Yet, on busy roads, it's like 30-mile-an-hour speed limits. It's weird. Yeah, I'm definitely going to... I'm going to have to go in there and... Well, this traffic's not going to stop, is it? Hmm. Right, after this cop car. No. Maybe not. Oh wow, there's been an accident. My chance, my chance, my chance. Let's get in here quick. Right, now we're gonna do a blindside reverse onto the main road. I cannot see a thing. Yeah, but the thing is, the AI will come right up to me. They'll come right up to me, so I won't be able to reverse out. Well... I still want to reverse into an AI though, that's going to be pretty bad. All of this because of sat nav. Well, we're really quite close to them now. Please wait there, please wait there, please wait there, please wait there. Do I hit one? No. Oh, that's not a good spot to wait, dude. Oh my god. god. Are you having a joke? Hopefully you will see more Forza videos coming out now. Oh dear. 58 minutes. Okay, there is a rest area coming up. I don't know how long it's going to take to get there. Oh, I need to get over. Okay, it's only a Prius. It's alright. Come on. Yeah, I don't know. With a trailer like this, you can really hear the engine working and feel it working. We have a lag spike there. Really can. I'm starting to think. With a trailer like this, I do need a bigger engine, but camera. But yeah, it's alright. We're getting off here, and then there should be a fuel place, which I think I'll refuel. 206. How long have we got? 192. I'm definitely gonna need to refuel, and I will rest before I start falling asleep at the wheel. Obviously not good. Let's get out before this Kenworth comes. There we go. Get this little construction area. I think I've picked up a trailer here before. I do remember it. 30 limit through here. And where is the fuel place? Well, I might get a hamburger as well, whilst I'm at it. Any of the viewers want one? Comment down below. Because then I know you've watched this far. If you want a hamburger, just say yes in the comments down below. Because then I know you've watched this far. And then I know who the true hardcore simulators viewers are. Right, let's turn the engine off. See how much this costs to refuel. £2.80. Now I do use the realistic gas price or whatever it's called. This is turning out quite expensive. Oh no, that's alright. 303. It seems a lot more expensive than usual. It really does. It's usually about 300 for a full tank, but that's only two-thirds a tank. Luckily, we're getting paid quite a bit for this journey then. But it is so nice to get those bigger payments at the end. So yeah, the new Xbox has been purchased. Now, I was looking at one for a while at Game, which is like a bit like GameStop if you're in America or something like that. And they were doing these pre-owned deals on Black Friday, whereas you can buy an Xbox One pre-owned, 500 gig. It has got loads of scratches on like the glossy bit, but I don't really care, to be honest. It's underneath a shelf, and all of them get like that eventually, so I'm not too bothered about the scratches. It works completely fine. They do a complete sort of overhaul on it, a game, like get all the dust out the ports, so it's really clean when I got it. Controllers weren't that clean, to be honest, but they did have like some bits on them, but the console was really nice. That's all I really want, to be honest. Look at that. Unusual. But we've made it. So, yeah, I'll talk to you about the rest of the story in the morning. There we go. 5:23 in the morning. So we got hang on. When's it got to be there? We have got, remains 7 hours to get it there, 4 hours, 40 minutes, 180 miles. Whoa, with this rescale, everywhere seems like an age away. Like before, on a journey this big, we'd be done by now, but apparently not. Why have we got 4BM on? Let's get going. But yeah, they completely cleaned all the ports on it, it was really nice. It only came with one controller. It came with the headset, which I don't use, but nice to have it. The way that road ends though, it's a bit weird. But yes, I'm happy about that. And I also had about £15 on my game voucher, so overall I got it for £130. I mean, it's not bad, is it? £130 for an Xbox One. It's not the S or anything, so I did look at the S, and it was about £200 in Black Friday. And one, I only had 150 to spend. Or 130, and then the rest was paid on my game card. But I don't know. I don't have a 4K TV or a HDR TV or anything, so I didn't really see the point in it, to be honest. Obviously, you can get the HDR gaming, but if you guys have a HDR TV with my recording, I don't know. I don't even know if my Elgato does record HDR. I don't know, but basically, I couldn't afford it. What's this guy doing? Look at this. It's like an equivalent spec. 389 just passed us, so if we went through a 389 instead of this, that's what it would look like. Kind of cool. Very yellow car. Yeah, let's, I don't know, he seems to take an age to get anywhere now in California because of these really low speed limits. And like the rescale, I mean, they seem to stay 10. Look how long it is. It is super flat. Let's put it 10th. Let's get it to cruise at 58. And we can just cruise down here. So that is the plan anyway with this company, as I was saying at the start. Work on the driver's trucks, upgrade them, and get some more of them. I think we're going to have to upgrade the garage next as well. So that's probably going to be a big purchase. I'm not going to sort of repay the loans manually, I'm just going to let them sort of flow away, because that's what I've always done. I don't really see the point in doing it. Because eventually the money does start coming in, and yeah, it sort of becomes irrelevant. But as I said before, I was really thinking that by now, episode 50-something, that we'd have a big company. I really didn't think this series would last this long, but it has. Which isn't a bad thing. I mean, it's a series where I get to talk, which I don't really do. I'm usually talking about the game, and time lapses, I obviously don't talk in them. It's just got music in the background. But yeah, kinda cool. It has been nice driving this W900. I've really grown to like it. It's very smooth. I love the engine. I mean, I believe it is still an engine mod. This that comes with it, but it's still really, really nice. And I am liking the rescale, I have to say. It is very, very good. I wasn't expecting it to be like this. I mean, the things they've added, it just feels like a different new, well, it feels like a completely new map now. It really does. I just wish they did it from the start. A bit of a shame, but I don't know. Obviously, we wouldn't have got it as early. But yeah. So I think that's the general updates about the DLC and then the Xbox situation. Then I have got some non-series videos coming up very soon for Christmas. I have got a, what was it now, like a preparing your game for winter video that I did one of those last year, but I want to do a higher quality one this year. And then I'm also going to do sort of a Christmas special. I'm not going to spoil it, but in my head it's going to look great. But in reality, I'm sort of hoping that ProMods is, or the latest version of ProMods was released quickly, because I want to go somewhere for the opening shots. I'm just going to leave it at that. I'm not going to spoil it, but if it works, it works. But I really need ProMods to get their updates sorted. Viva France DLC to come out and everything. But yeah, that's what I really want to do. I wanted to do a Halloween one as well, but I completely ran out of time. I had a really good idea for a Halloween video. I may do it next year, but we will see how that goes. It's going to be on American Truck and everything. But I don't know if the place that I was going to do it, this sort of haunted house place in this map, the SCS map, I don't know if they've removed it. I really don't. But we'll see how that goes. Look at it. It's so warm. It's dark outside. It's currently 7:24 PM when I'm recording this in real time. And it's so weird. Just driving, 20 degrees, sunshine. I mean, it's completely dark outside. It goes dark at about 4:30. Didn't even use the brakes then. How cool is that? Yeah, I do prefer the winter. I think I've said that before. I'm not a big fan of the summer. It's so hot to record in summer. I'm sitting here with a fan on the desk, and then you can hear the fan through the microphone, so it makes it really difficult. So I either can record and not record, or really warm and stick to my chair and record. So it's sort of a bit difficult. How much range have we got now? So we've used 23 gallons of fuel since we last filled up. According to this, we've still got 610 miles left. Whoa, is that a long train? Whoa, they made the train longer. Still not super long, but definitely better than before. That tree line. This vegetation, look at it. This guy's going for an overtake. There we go. They're going pretty quickly, so it's that sign back there said a 65 limit, but we've only got 55 or 58 for me. What's that? Is that like a trailer park? No, it's not. It's weird. It's like a massive lake there as well. Hang on. Have a look at the map. I think I remember this. Yeah, I remember this from a Top Gear episode where they could either go... Jeremy went in his LFA on this road. I believe it's like an interstate or something on that side. Or the lake. Obviously it's not as big in the game, but I think I remember this from Top Gear when they did the LFA Vanquish and the Viper. They were racing to the Mexican border to see who would have to go to Mexico to review that sports car that I can't remember the name of. I think I remember this. I was thinking, I don't know. So cool when you recognise places. It's all going very green all of a sudden. Like, it's weird to see like, bright green trees just popping out in the middle of sand. Whoa, 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 whoa! What's going on here? Hang on. Oh my gosh. The ice cream van has gone for a nap. Look at that. That is not... Oh dear. Well, it looks like I'm not going to get my ice creams. Hang on. G, fly speed. Turn. Oh dear. Right, could I have? No. That is so funny. My SCS had a laugh making that one. I love all the smoke as well. Why is smoke coming out of this car? Is he the one who rammed it over? Maybe. That is so funny. Just look at that. Get back on the road. And we've stalled. The brake off? Yes. Well, you can really feel the weight. So we got another 36 miles. Which shouldn't take us that much longer. Burger place. Oh, this is cool. I don't recognise all this. This looks really nicely detailed. Little house there. Very nice, and back out into the desert. Still lined with trees. And look at this, all farm area. Looks like it's been ploughed. Maybe not. Look how bumpy that is. I thought that would be ploughed, but... looks a bit bumpy to plant crops on there. I have to say, and it's like this green growing crop on this side. This is sort of grown. Look at this. It's like a farm area here. And that looks like it's just been harvested. Oh, nice. And back out into the desert. Look at how flat that is. That looks so good. Let's try not to crash into a sign at almost 60 miles an hour though. This looks very, very good. So it gives you the illusion that you're in the complete middle of nowhere. But we've made it. We have made it. Let's slow down here. Where are we dropping off? We're dropping at Gallon Oil. Don't know where that's going to be. But yeah, another successful journey in this truck with 27 grand. If I remember... the AI drivers should have brought in some money, so yes, I have noticed that, but 78 grand. We're going to be at over 100 at the end of this. And then it's, I believe, 100-ish, 180 for a new garage. And then 150 for a new truck. If we buy the sleeper version, which we are doing now. We're only buying the sleeper versions. So the AI can drive further and therefore get bigger jobs and more money overall. Which is better than upgrading them later on. Oh dear. Well, there's no sign saying, like, before that, that there's going to be a lane merge. Great testimony there. What's he doing? We are here anyway. Oh, fuel station. Nice. I don't drop off at many fuel stations, I have to say. Treason. Okay. It's just an easy drop off this time, all the way around. Very nice. Turn the indicator off. That was a very long journey, almost 400 miles I believe. It feels like an age now, it really does. This rescale was... it feels like a different game. It is so good. Oh. It's like a... oh, what's that, not going to reverse? There we go. Parking brake is on. Some kind of like scale or something. It's weird. Excellent! So we didn't get any damage. I think I like it. 27 grand. Is that going to push us into a new level? Yes, it is. Just. But yeah, that's quite a lot. Right, so where are we going to put our skill? I don't think... it's worth doing that yet. High value, 5% increase, 5% increase, 3% and 5%. I may do another one of these. Flammable liquids, flammable solids, corrosive substances, but I think I'm going to go with fragile. No. Change your mind. Let's go with corrosive. What can go wrong?
So let's have a look at our driver update. See how, oh, new upgrades. What can we get? New bumper. Some new pieces. W900 bigger chassis. Exhausts. And some nice things on the Peterbilt. Driver manager. We go. So Alicia, she's got 6 hours left. 10 grand. Wow, it's good. Josh, 8 grand. Oh, yes, yeah, it's going well. This is 7 grand. Look at that. So much better than it was before. 14 hours. 3 grand from a third job. 6 grand. I'm pretty happy with that. Pretty nice. Over 100 grand now. Let's have a look at the garage manager. Right, 4 out of 5, so we don't need to upgrade it or anything. We can just fill that spot there, but how much is it up? 180. Wow. So we can possibly by the end of next episode or the episode after get a truck. But anyway, thank you for watching. If you did enjoy and got this far, you must have enjoyed it, so click that like and subscribe. Anyway, thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll see you very soon. Goodbye.